Okay, so in this video we're looking at concentration time graphs. So on the y-axis we've got a concentration of reactants, and you expect all these graphs show that the concentration of the reactant goes down with time. If we look at A, it's a straight line. So it's been used up, but this gradient is constant all the way through. So you took the gradient of this line at any point, it will be the same. Remember, the gradient in this graph represents the rate. So the rate is constant no matter what the concentration of A. So we know then that A is zero order, because it's a straight line with a constant slope. So it doesn't matter what the concentration is, the gradient is the same, so the rate is the same. The concentration of A does not affect the rate of reaction. It is still a reactant, it's been used up, but it does not affect the rate. If we have a look at B, B is first order. It's downwardly sloping and it's got a constant half-life. That's the half-life is the time it takes for the concentration of the reactant to go down by half. We'll look at that more closely in a minute. And C, second order, is steeper than B. Okay. It levels out quicker. So if we look at the half-lives of these, we can tell which one is A, B, and C. So, for any first order reaction, the half-life is constant, independent of the concentration. So look at here then. We start off with 4 moles per dm cubed, and when that halves down to 2, we go across and we see how long that took. And we see it gives us here 17 minutes. And the time it takes to half again from 2 to 1, go across at 1 and down, and look at the difference here. This is the next half-life between these two lines. Again, it's 17 minutes. Half of one is a half, so we go across and down. We look at the gap there, it's 17 minutes again. So you see each one of these gaps represents a half-life. So to know if the half-life is constant, you've got to work out at least two, draw two, at least two boxes like this on your graph. Okay, in this case, we've got three boxes, and we can see that the half-life gaps in between these lines here along the x-axis are the same. So that's the same for all first-order reactions, it would have a constant half-life. If it was a zero order, it'd be a straight line like this. I've just drawn over the top. And you can see if I do the same, look at the gaps from here to here, compared to here, and then from here to here. That half-life is not constant. In fact, the half-life is getting smaller. Therefore, because the half-life is getting smaller, we know it's a zero order reaction. This one's a second order line that I've drawn. And you can see here, the half-life, go from 4 to 2. There's about 7, and then going from here to there, it's about 13, and it's getting bigger again. So, if we work out each half-life, the gap is not constant, it's getting bigger. So, that means that this particular, this red line, is second order.